Between 66 and 68 million years ago, during the Maastrichtian age of the late Cretaceous period, North America was under the dominion of a formidable tyrant, the Tyrannosaurus Rex. This creature is frequently portrayed as one of the most fearsome predators to have ever walked the earth, preying on anything that crossed its path. But was this really the case? The feeding behavior of Tyrannosaurus rex has been a subject of speculation ever since its discovery. While the majority of scientists support the idea of the tyrant king being a predator, there are also those who argue against it, suggesting that T. rex behaved more like a giant prehistoric vulture, a scavenger feeding on corpses, rather than an active hunter. The origin of this idea dates back to the early 1900s, following the discovery of a Gorgosaurus skeleton, a relative of T. rex. The specimen showed remarkably little wear on its teeth, hinting at a scavenging lifestyle. This led to the assumption that the Tyrannosaurus might have exhibited similar behavior. Nevertheless, this theory has lost its credibility over time, primarily due to the rapid replacement of theropods' teeth. Today, Jack Horner, an American paleontologist known for his description of Mayasaura and the leading position in the Chickenosaurus Project, stands as the primary advocate of the scavenger theory and has been actively pushing this idea since the 1990s. In his article, Horner proposed that T-Rex was exclusively a scavenger, a concept that was supposed to transform our understanding of this prehistoric giant. Later, he did make some exceptions, such as hunting small or weak animals. However, he still continues to advocate for its primary role as a scavenger. According to Horner and other paleontologists, several factors support the idea that T. rex was more of a scavenger than a hunter. To start with, compared to other known theropods, T. rex's arms were relatively small in proportion to the rest of its body, making them ineffective for grabbing onto struggling prey. In contrast, the king of dinosaurs possessed powerful jaws equipped with robust teeth capable of shattering bone, a fact supported by the discovery of bone fragments in coprolite remains. This suggests that T. rex might have primarily fed on carcasses, efficiently extracting all available nutrients, including bone marrow, for nourishment. Furthermore, due to its massive size with an estimated weight of over 8 tons, it is unlikely that T. rex was agile enough to catch fast-moving prey. However, this considerable bulk could have been an advantage when intimidating other scavengers off carcasses, asserting its dominance and securing the food for itself. Additionally, recent studies also highlight T. rex's large olfactory lobes, indicating a highly developed sense of smell. This adaptation could have enabled the dinosaur to detect carcasses over vast distances, similar to the scavenging behavior seen in modern vultures. Now, while these arguments may be compelling, none of them definitively eliminates the possibility of T. rex also being a formidable predator. In practical terms, this animal didn't necessarily need long arms to overpower its prey. Instead, it could have used its powerful jaws to pin it down and employ its deadly bite force to deliver the final blow. Also, the presence of bone fragments in fossilized feces cannot be considered as evidence for scavenging behavior. This is because we cannot dismiss the possibility that T. rex was, in fact, the predator who hunted down the prey and consumed it whole, bones included. Likewise, its exceptional sense of smell might have been used for more than just detecting carcasses. It could also have been an advantage when pursuing live prey. This ability, combined with its forward-facing eyes that provided binocular vision, a characteristic found in modern predators, suggests an efficient predator. Perhaps the strongest argument in favor of the scavenger theory is the dinosaur's immense size and its apparent lack of speed. Yet this view overlooks the fact that many animals coexisting with T. rex weren't particularly fast. In fact, some were as slow or even slower than the T. rex itself. Additionally, its anatomy offered another advantage. The animal's powerful legs featured relatively long thigh bones, suggesting that T-Rex was a fast walker, adapted for traveling long distances. Furthermore, other skeletal features like bone pneumaticity indicate a highly efficient bird-like respiratory system, enabling the animal to maintain its pace for a remarkably long time. Consequently, even though faster dinosaurs like hadrosaurs may have outrun the predator over short distances, T-Rex had the endurance to ultimately outpace the pursued prey, which would eventually drop from exhaustion or become too tired to fight back. In 1998, Kenneth Carpenter published a paper titled "Evidence of Predatory Behavior by Carnivorous Dinosaurs." In this study, he described the findings of a fossilized Edmontosaurus, a hadrosaurid from the late Cretaceous period, found in the Hell Creek Formation. The specimen displayed evidence of inflicted damage to its tail vertebra. However, the damaged area bears signs of partial healing, suggesting that the animal not only survived the attack, but also regrew bone in the affected areas. As for the attacker's identity, it must have been a predator of considerable size, at least as tall as, if not taller than, the Edmontosaurus, reaching a height of at least 2.9 meters above the ground. Considering the species known from the Hell Creek Formation, the only theropod that fits these criteria and could have inflicted such an injury is the Tyrannosaurus rex. However, the first definitive evidence of Tyrannosaurus rex's predatory behavior was uncovered in 2007, with the discovery of another hadrosaurid vertebra, which was later described in 2013 by David Burnham. This vertebra shows the tip of an adult Tyrannosaurus tooth embedded within it, surrounded by new bone growth, which points to a failed predatory attempt by the Tyrannosaurus. The scenario likely unfolded with the Tyrannosaurus biting the hadrosaur's tail, but during the struggle, the prey managed to escape, breaking off a piece of the predator's tooth in the process. In summary, the most plausible explanation is that T-Rex, much like many present-day carnivores, played a dual role as both a predator, actively hunting live prey, and an opportunistic scavenger, feeding on carcasses during periods of food scarcity. To delve deeper into Tyrannosaurus rex's behavior, diet, anatomy, or its discovery, don't forget to check out this video.